Hello, in this video we'll put into practice all the things we learned in the previous videos to create this sci-fi table here. The design is made by Vitaly Bulgarov. You can find this image as well as many other ones on his site if you want to download this concept. And we are going to model the table, the legs of a table, and without the center mechanism, this cylinder here. This is not an overly complicated piece, but it will allow us to use different tools and take a look at the MoI workflow for hard surface design. Okay, so let's get started with the top piece. It is a square table with a glass panel in the center. So let's start by creating this top piece, the outer metal. So I will go to my top view, spacebar. I'll use my hotkeys for this video, but you can always pick the tools manually by clicking on the side panel here. Okay, so let's pick the rectangle tool, Alt 3, left click on the origin. And I want a square, so I will lock it here on the axis, like this. Left click to confirm. We can immediately see that it has chamfer on all the edges, on all the angles. So I will select my square and Ctrl F for chamfer. I want all the points in this case, so I will simply right click to confirm. And left click on the grid and pick a distance by left clicking again. Something like this, I think it's okay. Right click to confirm. Let's also make the glass panel in the center. It's very easy. Let's pick the rectangle tool again, Alt 3. Left click on the origin. It's another square, so I will simply lock it here. Pick something like this. Will be okay. Left click to confirm. It probably has a small fillet, I think. So let's select the square, Ctrl V, and then right click to confirm because we want all the angles, all the points, and pick the distance. Very, very small, like this. Right click to confirm. Before going further, let's extrude this wall shape. I will select everything and press the E key for extrude. I will give it this thickness here and let's delete the curves. If you notice, it has these very small paneling details. One is here and the other one is here. We also have another panel detail here and on the opposite side as well. Let's make the long one. I'll go to the top view, pick the rectangle tool, so Alt 3. Let's click here, left click, this thickness is okay. I will move it here. Let's press E for extrude and I will move it here. Let's delete the curve. I will also jump to the top view and press Shift M for mirror. Let's pick the center, left click, and then simply move the mouse and the left click so we have the cube on the other side as well. And then I will select my base table here, press the B key for boolean subtract, and I will select this cube and this cube, right click, and we have this detail. Let's also make this detail here, which is another panel, I think. So let's jump to the top view again. So spacebar, spacebar. And I will pick the rectangle tool again, Alt 3. Snap it here to the center and snap it here. Left click to confirm. Select this rectangle. Press the G key for grab or move. Left click on the center and now we can move it around. So this was here more or less. S key and left click here on the middle and left click on the X axis and let's make it longer like this. Okay, now let's jump to the 3D view press the E key for extrude, and I will make it very small like this and delete the curve. Then let's select it, press the G key, left click here and snap it on the Z axis, left click, then select our table, B key for boolean subtract, left click on the cube here, right click. Let's make the glass panel because we only have the hole right now. It looks like it is either a wall piece of glass or two panels, one here on the top and one on the bottom. Let's make it with two panels. I think it looks better. So select the table, select this edge here, this edge, and press Alt A to select the wall loop, and then press the point on the numpad to fill the face. Let's make the same process for the top part. So let's select these two edges, Alt A and point. Okay, so now we have our two panels of glass. We can give the table a color. So I will go to the browser. Let's leave it black. And for the two glass panels, I will use a cyan. Okay, I will also call them glass, so I can hide them. Click on the table and call it table top. Now let's hide the glass, and I will select the wall table and give it a small fillet. So Ctrl B, 0.01 I think is the way to go, otherwise we get problems with intersecting fillets and the mesh become broken. Let's press done and let's enable the glass again. Let's create the legs of a table. So as we can see, they are very simple, just a long rectangle goes up and then we have the same rectangle on the top. So here we will make it from the side view, this time the right view. So I will create the profile. Alt 1 for polyline. Let me hide our table. I will use the center. So origin. Let's also enable the grid snap. Left click here. Left click on the origin. Then I will go up about here. Left click here. Right click to confirm. However, I want this two to be longer, so I will select my polyline, press the P key to show the points, select this two, let's move them here. Okay, I think it's too tall. Something like this, I think it will work. Press the P key again to hide the points. Select the polyline and then E for extrude. Left click to confirm. I move it two square grids. Let's delete the curve. Let's disable the grid snap. And let's use the shell command to give it some thickness. Let's use the center line so it will extrude on both directions. For the thickness, I think something like this, it will work, maybe a little less, and done. Let's select this, edge here, as well as the top, Ctrl B, because I want to fillet it. This is way too much. Okay, something like this, 0.13, right click to confirm. Then I select this edge and this edge, Ctrl B again. Let's use the same radius and right click to confirm. Then let's select the wall object, Ctrl B. Let's give it a very small fillet. Like this, right click to confirm. Now, if you notice, they have some kind of bolts, I think, so we can make them without much problem. But first, let's give it a name. So I'll call it table leg. Add a new style. I will make it like this, a grayish tone. We can go to the top view, so spacebar, spacebar, Alt 5 for circle. Let's create a circle here, and then right click to pick the tool again. Left click on the center, let's make it this. Then left click on the small circle, G key, left click on the center, and move it up. Then I will select the bigger circle and L key for loft and done. Then we can delete the curves. Let's select this bolt and I will simply scale it in the top view and move it using the G key and the left click point. Let me see the dimension here. So let me scale it. Okay, it's pretty good. Let's go to the right view and rotate it 180 degrees like this. With the bolt in this position, I will normally use the copy command to duplicate the various bolts onto the surface, but in this case, we can simply use the mirror. So let me go to the top view, spacebar. Let's select the bolt. Then I will press Shift M for mirror and I will mirror it in the center here. And on the Y axis, left click, select these two bolts. Let's first move them onto the surface. G key, let's pick the middle and move it inside like this. And then Shift M for mirror, let's pick the middle point, left click on the Y axis. Okay, it's just a matter of selecting the leg, press the B key, select all the bolts and right click to perform a Boolean operation. And then you can fill it if you want. We will do it straight away. Let's select these two edges, Ctrl B like this, right click. And let's repeat the process for the other one. Right click and right click again. Sometimes if you select all the objects you want to fill it at once, it doesn't work. So that's why I always fill it an object and then simply repeat the command for the other one by selecting the edges again, right click. So we have the fillet tool again with the same radius and then right click to confirm. Same thing here, right click and right click. Now let's also make this little hole here, and just to show you a different workflow, we'll make the hole just with the circle tool by extruding it. So let's go to the front view, Alt 5 to pick the circle and left click on the center, something like this, left click to confirm. Let's pick the circle, E for extrude, and let's move it inside a little bit, left click, then delete the curve, select our leg, B for boolean subtract, select the circle that we just extruded and then right click. Okay, so let's select the outer circle, Ctrl F for chamfer. Let's pick the width, like this, right click to confirm. Select this inner circle, Ctrl B for fillet. Let's pick a very small one, like this, right click to confirm. Then let's say there is a bolt inside, so Alt 5, and I will pick a radius like this, select this circle, move it a little bit inside, press the G key, left click on the center and move it here. Okay, let me disable the object snap. Okay, and then E key for extrude and let's move it here and let's delete the circle. Let's enable the object snap again, select our bolt, outer edge, and then Ctrl B, and I think this is already looking good, so right click to confirm. You can make the same thing for all these holes, but I leave it as they are for this tutorial. Okay, now let's duplicate the leg into 3. I'll go to the top view, so using the spacebar key, select this leg and move it here. Then I will press the Shift S for circular array origin, item count 3, angle 360. Let's press done. Then I will move. Let's press the G key, select the middle point and move it here on the origin. Select this one, press the G key on the middle point of the fillet and move it here on the middle. This, and then let's do the same for this one. I'll pick the middle point, use the G key, and then snap it here. Okay, we have three legs. Now let me select this table with the glass, and let me jump to the front view. Oh, this is our bolt. Let me hide the glass and the table. So this is our bolt. Let's give it the name bolt and ray material as well. Let me hide it. Let me select top table and press the G key, left click on the center, just move it up so we can show the legs. G key on the middle point of this and then snap it here. Okay, now let's go to the top view, select the table top by left clicking here and the glass, press the G key, right click to confirm, bounding box center, and I will move it. Okay, I noticed that our bolt is not present in the other one because I forgot to make the circular array for it. Let me simply select it, Shift D for copy. I'll pick the center and let's place it here. If you notice, the bolt is not in the correct orientation, so I'll use the orient tool, pick base origin, our face here with the fillet, then right click to confirm because the Z axis is fine, and I will snap it to the center. Okay, done. Then I'll use the G key, snap it to the center and move it out, and then I will repeat the same process for this one. So Shift D, pick the center, okay, here we go. Let me give it the same material of the leg, of the legs and bolts. Okay. Okay, so this concludes the practice for this video. In the next one, I will show you how to export it, choose the various options that MoI offers for triangulation and so on, and then we will render it inside Blender. So let's save it. Let's click on the save. You should save it as OpenNURBS 3DM. This is a format that MoI use. However, it can also be opened by other software. So MoI doesn't use a proprietary file format for the projects, which is a nice thing. So I will simply save it in a location. And let's save it. And there we go. You have your file project saved. Okay, so if you enjoyed this video, leave a like to support the channel. Subscribe to stay up to date with the latest contents. If you have any questions, comment below, and I'll see you in the next one.